Ringmaster, ranged support, disabler, escape, dark carnival barker, ability, passive. Ringmaster receives a random single-use dark carnival souvenir whenever an enemy hero dies within 925 units of him. Additional souvenirs are held as charges. If Ringmaster does not have a souvenir when he respawns, he will be granted one. Souvenirs of the Dark Carnival include a funhouse mirror, a strongman tonic, and a whoopee cushion. Tame the beasts. Ability, damage type, magical, channeled, dispellable, but doesn't pierce debuff immunity. Channeled. Ringmaster twirls his whip for up to 1 second, then cracks it. Whipped enemies are damaged and flee in fear from Ringmaster. Channel time exponentially increases damage and extends the fear duration, but reduces the radius. Radius start 450, radius end 200. Damage 45 up to 120, max damage 180 up to 480, that's a lot. Minimum fear duration 0.1 to up to 0.4, max fear duration 0.6 up to 1.2. 16 seconds, 14, 12, 10. Mana cost 90 up to 135. What is this green stuff? It's probably the range 700 to 850. From unhappy crowds to unruly acts, nothing persuades a pack of animals quite like the crack of the Ringmaster's whip. And now I press Alt, maybe there's some extra info. Nope. Let's just see here quickly, is there any extra info? If you press Alt, here's something. Whoopee cushion. Well, then I'll go over the Dark Carnival souvenirs. So if you look at Funhouse Mirror, nothing happens, but more details, press Alt. Funhouse Mirror. Use Proportion Distortion. Creates one imperfect image of your hero that lasts 18 seconds. Your illusion deals 28% and takes 300% damage. Has a 0.2 second casting during which you are invulnerable. Strongman tonic, allied heroes, affected unit target, dispellable, use forcefully, imbibe, temporarily increases an allied hero's strength by 5 plus 1.5 per Ringmaster's level for 8 seconds. The effect holds for 4 seconds and then deteriorates over the duration. Whoopee cushion. Use whoopsie. Whoopsie propels your hero forward 400 units, so like a leap from Mirana. Leaves a 200 radius stink cloud behind for 3 seconds that slows enemies by 30%. So a little bit like Bristleback nasal goo. And let's see, next one, next spell, escape act. Ability, unit target, allied heroes, also does not pierce debuff immunity, this cannot be dispelled. Ringmaster packs himself or an allied hero into a mobile extra dimensional box. Boxed units gain phased movement, slow resistance, bonus magic resistance, and bonus movement speed. They are also untargetable, muted, silenced, and disarmed. The box will pop open after the effect expires or it moves more than 500 units away. Duration 2 up to 3.2 seconds, bonus movement speed 5 up to 20%. Bonus magic resistance 50, 60, 70, 80%. Well, that's a lot of magic resistance on level 4. Slow resistance 100%. That's also very strong. So cooldown 38 seconds, level 4 20 seconds, only 80 mana cost, 600 range, I guess the green stuff is the range. An adept assistant has nothing to fear within the confines of the box. An amateur has much darker prospects indeed. So you put someone into a box and you save him for 3.2 seconds. While the first spell fears an opponent and does a lot of damage on level 4, 480. Next one, Impalement Arts, point target, magical. Does not pierce debuff immunity, but it's dispellable. Ringmaster throws one of his daggers to a precise point of his choosing. If he strikes an enemy, the dagger deals impact damage, briefly slows the unit hit, and causes them to bleed. The bleeding deals a percentage of the victim's maximum health in damage every second to heroes and flat damage per second to creeps. Every second to heroes and flat damage per second to creeps. So you have 1 to 4 charges, base charge restore time 17. So this is a bit like Earth Spirit Stones, you have some charges and they restore after 17 seconds. 75 impact damage, max health damage per second only for heroes, 3.5% up to 5% on level 4. Damage per second, creeps 100, so if you have 4 charges, 400 damage to creeps, you can almost clear the wave, we'll test it. Duration 4 seconds, movement slow 100%, slow duration 0.8, 1 cooldown, only 1 second cooldown, 80 mana cost, it's not much. 2400 range? What? That's so high. Passed down through generations. It simply wouldn't be a kettle circus without the great Cogliostro's signature trick. And his ultimate, Wheel of Wonder, ability point target, damage type magical. Pierces debuff immunity, no, dispellable, cannot be dispelled. So let's quickly see your magical. This is the escape for your teammate or himself with the box. Also magical, so you do lots of magical damage. Range support disabler, but no physical, only right clicks are physical. Continuing with this ultimate, Ringmaster rolls the Wheel of Wonder to the targeted location, knocking aside enemies along the way. After it reaches its target, enemies in range of the wheel take damage over time and are slowed by 50%. Enemy heroes who face the wheel for more than 0.5 seconds are mesmerized and drawn towards it. The first enemy to be mesmerized triggers a timer for the wheel to explode. If the timer is not triggered, it will automatically explode after 8 seconds. It has a minimum range of 700, radius 600. That's like 2 RPs or half Ravage, something like that. Timer duration, the heroes I talked about would be Magnus and Tidehunter. Radius is 600, timer duration 2.75, 3.25, aura damage per second 50, 75, 100 damage, explosion damage 300, 450, 600 damage. That's a lot of damage for his ultimate. It has 90 second cooldown, 80, 70, so the cooldown is much lower than reverse polarity from Magnus or Tidehunter Ravage. Or if I think about support heroes, what would be a support hero with such a high cooldown? Maybe Lion Finger of Death has a higher cooldown. Grimstone's ultimate has a lower cooldown. Hoodwink ulti has a lower cooldown. I mean, there are a lot of support heroes that have low cooldowns. So this is actually quite high. 70 seconds for a support. Mana cost 175, 275, 375. Well, you better not buy that many glimmer capes, four staffs and stuff like this. You're gonna need 375 mana and 1400 range. No brave friends. Illusions are for charlatans and card sharks. What you witness today is the power of true magic, but only if you dare set your gaze upon the mesmerizing wheel. So, and what else does it say here? Welcome, welcome, one and all, to a stage-lit extravaganza for the ages. Prepare to have your senses shattered, your expectations demolished, your ancients smashed to ruins. Witness the impossible feats and daring do of the one and only clockwork marvel, the great Cogliostro Kettle Ringmaster, torture artist, genius in his own time, here now for the soul agony and entertainment of any hero bold enough to draw back the crimson carnival curtain and behold what mysteries await inside. The mistake most maestros make is waiting for the public to come to them. The ringmaster knows you need to go out and find your audience, drag them to you and make them watch. So he's like a street musician, street artist, he goes out. Don't stay in your base, go out on your lanes. So let's have a quick look at the talent tree and aghanims. The talent tree, what do you get? Plus 200 escape act cast range or plus 75 tame the beast radius. Escape act plus 200 range, so you would have instead of 600 800 range to put yourself or an ally into a mobile box. 600, that would be a talent you should get. That's a high range. 800 if you buy Etherlands or get one of the neutral items that extends your range, you can save people. Plus 75 Tame the Beast radius. What is the Tame the Beast again? It's the first spell. So this would be 850 plus 75. I mean, 850 on level 4 is already high. I don't think you need this. Next, debuff immunity while channeling Tame the Beasts or Impalement Arts penetrates one target. Debuff immunity while channeling Tame of the Beasts. This sounds quite good, but do you really need it? You twirl your whip for 1 second. Do you really need the debuff immunity while channeling it? You're probably just standing back. Maybe in some matches against the heroes you want debuff immunity, but in other times you don't need it. So you can take the other one. Impalement Arts penetrates one target. Ringmaster throws one of his daggers to a precise point of his choosing. If he strikes an enemy, the dagger deals impact damage, briefly slows the unit hit and causes them to bleed and impale and penetrates the target. So that would be the better choice, the right one for level 15 and the left one for level 10, but it's situational, so that's good that you have options, you're flexible. For level 20, what do we get here? Plus 75 slash plus 300 Tame the Beasts minimum max damage. Plus 75, plus 300, wow, you would do 480, 500, 550, 555, or 780 max damage, what the hell, that's so much, 780 damage. you know, some lion support plus 5 player walks around. He's like, I'm gonna place a ward, and then this ringmaster dude throws one of his Tame the Beasts at him and twirls his whip. And this lion is truly damaged and flees in fear of the ringmaster. So if he throws the Tame the Beasts and this impalement arts dagger, the position 5 is not gonna be alive anymore, unless he has Aeon Disc, but that never happens, right? You only get your 4 stuff and maybe plus 1 item or upgraded boots. And what do we have here? Like Boots of Bearing or Guardian Greaves. Oftentimes you only have money for Tranquil Boots plus 5 dog. So plus 1 second impalement arts bleed and slow duration. Plus 1 second, it's 4 seconds, so that would be 5. 5. Okay. But the left one, Tame the Beast, extra damage sounds a bit better. Although, slow duration, 5 seconds and 100% slow duration, you literally cannot move. You're not moving if you don't have some blink ability for stuff. You cannot move for 5 seconds. So it's also situational. You can try that out in your main matches. And what do we get for level 25? Escape Act grants strong dispel and flying, or plus 100 wheel radius and range. The Wheel of Wonder, plus 100. That doesn't look that much. I don't think you need it. What, plus 100? Escape Act grants strong dispel and flying. Well, this is absolutely awesome if you can fly. At level 25, you can fly and get a strong dispel. Who else gives a strong dispel? I think was it Grimstroke? I think that was Grimstroke 25 talent on his ink, but I don't remember exactly. And then let's have a look at Aghanim Scepter. You should probably take the strong dispel and flying. There's also this tier 5 item where you can fly. And also, did you know the TI player who has been at the International 11 times is actually called Fly? He's gonna be playing in, what is it, 12 days, 11 days, 10 days in Copenhagen, the International 2024 in Europe, Denmark. So let's have a look at Aghanim Scepter. Hero Scepter upgrade. Ringmaster does not have yet an Aghanim Scepter upgrade. Valve often released heroes that did not have a scepter or shard. You can say it's lazy, but it's also good to not have another scepter. We already have to learn the new spells, talents, and those extra dark carnival souvenirs. We need to learn the Whoopsie, Forceful Imbibe, Proportion Distortion, Funhouse Mirror, Strongman Tonic, Whoopie Cushion, Wheel of Wonder, Impalement Arts, Escape Act, Tame the Beasts, Facet, Dark Carnival Barker, Talent Tree, and the new Aghanim Shard, which they added already. Sometimes they release a hero who does not have an Aghanim Shard either, but not this time he has it. So what do we get as free shard when you take the Tormentor, or if you choose to spend your 1,400 gold on the Aghanim Shard, you also get one. So we have a spotlight new ability. Ringmaster shines a spotlight that sweeps over an area. So you have a spotlight like in some theater or movie show. Enemies in the light have a chance to miss their attacks and are revealed if invisible. Illusions hit by the beam fade away, losing a percentage of their maximum health each second. These effects linger for 0.3 seconds after leaving the light. So against illusion heroes like PL and CK Ultimate, or just Manta style item heroes, the illusions fade away, losing health each second. But they only linger for 0.3 seconds after leaving the light. I'm not sure if this is gonna be that useful. Some illusions that are living for a lot of seconds, or Mantas illusions, you can just walk away with them, micro them away. And what was the sentence before? Enemies in the light have a chance to miss their attacks and are revealed if invisible. So if there's some Rikimaru walking around, or some people invis, they're in the Shadowblade Silver Edge walking around, and you want to see them, now they are revealed. And they cannot be like, oh, I'm just gonna Silver Edge crit maybe the Ringmaster and you're dead immediately as support. No, you are revealed, sir, so I have time to react, because I don't like dying in 1 second. I'm already so slow playing my boss 5. Leave me alone with your Silver Edge. Radius 550, illusion max health loss 50%, miss chance only 30%. I mean, it shouldn't be too strong, it's a shard overall. But illusion max health loss 50%, that's not much. Duration 8 seconds. 8 seconds. So you just walk away with your Mantis style illusion to one of opposite direction or vertical direction, left, right, top, up, somewhere else or down, depends where the spotlight is, and you can farm some jungle creeps maybe, or the fight continues elsewhere. 30 seconds cooldown only 50 mana, so every 30 seconds you can just spam the spotlight. So let's test it, launch into demo mode. Let's test it, it's loading. Oh, what is this screen? I just got some laundry item from Candyworks Caravan. And there we go. So, 1 second. So, Ringmaster. For intelligence heroes, every point in intelligence also increases main attack damage by 1. Attack type. Ranged. This hero's ability mechanics require a moderate degree of skill, coordination, and timing to execute 2 stars. Support can focus less on amassing gold and items and more on using their abilities to gain an advantage for the team. Nuker can quickly kill enemy heroes using high damage spells with low cooldowns. Escape has the ability to quickly avoid death. Disabler has a guaranteed disable for 1 or more of their spells. I already talked about the innate and the Aghanim Scepters and all the spells. But here we can see the spotlight again. So this is the spotlight. Ringmaster places, it moves around like in a movie scene or theater. Wheel of Wonder, his ultimate drags heroes together and then explodes. Here we have Tame the Beast, his Q first spell. So it twirls the whip on creeps, and then the creeps walk away. Escape act, you turn into a box and move around for 2 seconds or 3.2 seconds on level 4. Or you use it on a teammate. Here in the demo they show they used it on an X hero. turns into a box, and then he quickly moves away. Let's see it one more time. It's a quick, slow resistance, magic resistance. So you save a teammate for 2 to 3.2 seconds. Impalement arts. Here you throw a dagger on a hero and the hero bleeds, and you can see the animation, it just the dagger keeps hitting. Tide Hunter in this case. Funhouse Mirror. You have a 18 seconds illusion. Walks around, deals 28% damage and takes 300 damage. Strongman Tonic. Increases an allied hero's strength by 5. Plus 1.5 Ringmaster's level for 8 seconds. For 4 seconds, so you can see the Tide Hunter gets a bit bigger. Strength by 5 per Ringmaster's level. Because Tide Hunter got changed a little bit, like half a year ago, and he gets bigger from level 1 to 30. And whoopee cushion, so you have a small leap forward, or in that direction you're facing, you propel forward. And behind you is the cloud, like a bristleback cloud. So if you're a support running away, you slow them for 30 seconds and leave some cloud. 13 strength, 23 strength, 13 agility, 25 int. This damage is okay, 48 to 58, 3.2 armor. That's fine, you can get the buckler. Mechanism, move speed 315, that's fine. Base attack time 1.7, that's a bit slow, but I guess it's fine. Attack speed 113, attack range 575, so not 600. 375 mana, 626 health, that's also good. No items yet added. Hair, weapon, armor, hands. He already has really cool hands, you don't even need to make him an item for this. But the people will make items. Taunt, not yet. Effigy, not yet. Oh, there's the new arrival effigy of the International 2024. And ability effects, not yet. Hero looks really cool. So let's go into demo. Here we are, the demo mode.
Scouting location?
So let's see. Let's see here. Can my audio please work? Can my audio please work?
Perfect.
So let's quickly test this hero. You have to tame the beast. Can cast it 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Can cast it here. Or you can cancel it 1, 2, 3, 4, or just 1, 2, 3, 3. 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. So you can test it a bit. Then this one you click on yourself, or you can click on an ally. Turn this guy into a box. What happens if you use force stuff? I cannot target him. So does not do that much damage. It's under 1180, but you are feared. So let's go back to full HP and Underlord. Feared and one hit 500. 670 to 500, and it has a 16-second cooldown. Cannot put an opponent into the box. So let's see if I cast it like this. How much HP does he have? Oh, nothing. It is in the radius, but since it's moving towards the circle, the outer circle does nothing. I could do this and still miss. You have to be in the inner circle here. So don't forget this. You cast on an opponent and you think you're gonna, like, you cast like this, you think you're gonna do a lot of damage, but you actually don't do anything. So you have to be quite close. I mean, this is close. So you want to buy other lands. So you have some more distance. And the... Oops. And the item I was looking for was... Where is it? Increases cast range. Psychic Headband. So you have Etherlands and Psychic Headband, you can stand like this. It's much better to have this distance. Because without it, you are very close. You're like this. It's very close. So, what else do we have? We have Impairment Arts level up. Oh, okay. Let's put some Underlords here. You can throw these at a long range. How far does it go? Does it go into the shadow here? Yes. Does it go all the way here? I place a ward. I mean, look at this cast range. What the hell? How do you even do this? Like, it's not my screen, it's more than my screen. Check this out. Pew. I mean, people have so much time to react. Let's see. I'll throw it. Let's give this guy view neutral items, this, and then travels. Four stuff, blink. So I have a lot of time to react. Of course, it fails. And let's do it again. Wait, why does this not work? Here. Stop attacking. So I can blink away, move away. So let's see. He shoots this, I can force stuff out, but I could even blink in again. Let's try again. You know, maybe some teammate. Look, this is what's gonna happen. You throw this, and some teammate is going to force you. And then, if I would be a bit quicker. So, I'm gonna throw the dagger. He forces me and... whoops. I did do this. Hold on. Item is muted. It was still bleeding. What is this bleeding? 4 seconds. Of course, now I misclicked. So now it should be working. Item is muted. Oh, because I'm an opponent. Now it works. So you throw your support standing back. You throw Impalement Arts dagger. Your teammate tries to save you, but you react at the same time. You blink, and you might blink into the dagger. Can happen. Your teammate just wants to save you, but you react at the same time, and then. You're in it because it flies all the way such a high distance. 2725 2400, let's level up. 2400 on level 4. It was only level 1, remember? Now I have 2725. And let's see about the Wheel of Wonder. So I have a lot of heroes. And Wheel of Wonder. They all go there. And then you throw some darts. And you fear them. Wheel of Wonder. So Wheel of Wonder Rampage. And then your teammate is watching you. Every second you throw a dart at your teammate, he's taunting, but you put him into a box. That's a good hero. What's suggested for this hero? Aghanims. Does not have an Aghanims yet, so that's not what we're gonna buy. And let's see about the shard spotlight. Throw a spotlight here. Okay. Strongman tonic. Look at your teammate, he goes, he's big now. Now I have an illusion. It looks so funny. Look at this illusion. Whoopee cushion, I jump around. Can I also make enemies bigger? Nope, only teammates. Increases in allied heroes. Strength and level. So. bit bigger now. Funhouse. Need your illusion. You can put it on a hotkey. Here. And this illusion cannot really do anything other than hitting. And here I jump again. So you need to watch out here. What kind of spell do we have? Which one? Spotlight every 30 seconds. 15 seconds for this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Put them into a box. Cast the ultimate. Force them around. Maybe Glimmer Cape a teammate. And then again. This. Jump around. And suddenly I have no mana anymore. So. Need some arcane boots. And what else? What would be a good item? I mean, Hex is always very good, but you usually never get it. You only get Glimmer Cape, Force Staff, Guardian Greaves, or sometimes Boots of Bearing. Sometimes you build drums, they're expensive. They are not expensive, they're cheap. 1650 dispatch. Vladimir's Offering, Vessel. Vessel, I don't know. Vessel could be good too. You buy Vessel. You walk closely. Throw some darts, daggers. And then you get a Vessel charge. Boots of Bearing. You move quite quickly with Boots of Bearing. 400 and now I'm 460. Nobody's gonna get me like this. Glimmer Cape slows me a little bit. No, actually it does not. Glimmer Cape gives me 40 movement speed. They changed that, you're so fast. Force stuff. And then if I have the right whoopee, if I have the right one, I can also whoopee around. But this is recharging. 17 seconds it said, or 18 seconds. Let's wait a bit. Now it's back. So the recharge time was 18 seconds illusion, or what? I wanna know the recharge time. Souvenirs. If Ringmaster does not have a souvenir when he respawns, he will be granted one. Ringmaster receives a random single use dark kind of a souvenir whenever an enemy hero dies. Okay. But that's not my question. Where do I see? Where can I see what the cooldown is? Introducing. I already forgot what I read before at the start. I think it was 18 seconds, but okay, let's just count. I'm gonna cast this on myself. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61. Okay, I'm gonna stop here. Why is this taking so long? Okay, I have to go back to the start of the video and reread, because it doesn't say gather souvenirs from kills and assists. But didn't they say I have a 18 seconds restore time? So this is impalement arts 17 seconds, escape act 38, 32, 26, 20. Tame the beast 16, 14, 12, 10. Spotlight. What spotlight is 30 seconds. Wheel of Wonder 90 seconds. AT 70. It doesn't give any information here other than get kills and assists. But what if I don't get any kills? What if I don't get any kills and or assists? What if our team is not winning anything, or if I'm playing against them and they're not winning? By the way, can I do this illusion bigger? Can put the illusion into a box? Interesting. Mantle style. Mantle style illusion did not get bigger. Or did it? No.
Only God can judge me.
That right?
Only God, baby. Nobody else.
Nobody else.
All you other motherfuckers, get out of my business.
Really?
Perhaps I was blind to the facts. Stabbed in the back, I couldn't trust my own home.